We are at the sarpanch here. So we are at the river. Let me introduce you to the sarpanch. Rajesh Dupane. Sarpanch.
Bola.
Shankar Songal.
Bola.
Ram Ram.
Ram Ram.
Kaay tumcha gavi kaay kaam kadle?
Amcha gavi Kalu nadiche naditle kirtiche us pakadayche.
Ase hoy hi nadi Kalu nadi hai?
Ha Kalu nadi.
An ma hi evda sagal bharle tacha kaay upyog?
शेतकऱ्याच्या बांधाला जर आपण भराव लावला तर शेतकऱ्याचा जमिनीचे धूप थांबेल,
त्या फायदा होईल,
फायदा होईल. आणि त्यांना जर पाण्याची पातळी वाढली तर त्यांचा बागायत करण्यासाठी पण फायदा होईल.
बर, मग इथं पाणी उपसून पण घेता येईल,
उपसून पण घेता येईल.
आणि त्याची पाण्याची पातळी वाढली की त्याचा पण उपयोग होईल,
उपयोग होईल.
म्हणजे सध्या एवढी बागायत आहे त्याच्यापेक्षा जास्त बागायत होईल,
जास्त बागायत होईल.
आणि तर पाणी बी भरपूर साठेल,
पाण्याचा साठा पण पाणी पातळी वाढून पूर्ण अजून 7-8 महिने पाणी पुरून जाईल ते.
बर,
पाणी पातळी वाढल्यावर.
हे किती वर्षात हे काम केलेलं नाही?
हे जवळजवळ 12 वर्षे झाले असतील.
याला कॅम्प केलंच नाही कधी, बांधल्यापासून कधी काढलंच नाही,
त्यापासून कोणी काही केलंच नाही आहे, तसंच आहे.
बर बर,
पहिल्यांदाच तुमची संस्था आता आमच्या आदिवासीसाठी कार्य करत आहे.
बर, म्हणजे चांगलं काम आहे आपण करतोय. चला बरं, तुम्ही पण याच्याबद्दल आम्हाला सहकार्य दिलं याच्याबद्दल तुमचे धन्यवाद. तुमच्या खेळ पण याच्यामध्ये सहभागी होईल अशी मी आशा करतो. हां बरं, आता मी असं करतो सगळ्या लोकांना समजायला म्हणून, कारण लोकांना घरी बसून समजत नाही ना. तर आता मी त्यांना काय केटीचा बांध दाखवतो आणि कसं ते सगळं जरा व्हिडिओ काढून दाखवतो.
हां
बरं, सो यू कॅन सी दिस केटी बंधारा, दिस यू कॅन सी दिस द वॉल. ओके, यू कॅन हार्डली सी बिकॉज इट्स ऑल फुल. ओके, बट आय विल वॉक ऑन द वॉल, देन यू विल नो. तुला कळलं रे? हां, दिस राजेश, राजेश हिलम, जरा असं होणार ना, राजेश हिलम, ही इज वर्किंग विथ मी, ही इज फ्रॉम अ क्लोज बाय पाडा कॉल न्याहाडी पाडा. काय राजेश, तू काय काम करणार इकडं? हां, देखरेखचं म्हण ना, हां देखरेखचं काम करणार, मोजमापाचं काम करणार. हां, म्हणजे राजेश इथं कायम राहणार आहे, सो ही विल ॲक्च्युली सी दॅट द वर्क इज गोईंग ऑन वेल. ओके राजेश, राजेश बोला घाबरायच नाही कधी. सो वी विल, आय विल शो यू द वॉल नाव. ओके, दिस इज द वॉल. नाव यू कॅन ॲप्रिशिएट द वॉल वेन यू सी इट ऑन द अदर साईड. सी द वॉल. ओके, यू कॅन ॲटलीस्ट सी इट इज 10 फीट टॉल. ओके, देर इज सम वॉटर अक्युमुलेशन बिकॉज ऑफ लिकेज ऑर वॉट एवर, बट ऑन दिस साईड यू कॅन हार्डली सी एनी वॉल. No wonder, because it's all full with muck. That is exactly what we are trying to clear. Now, I would have walked through all this, but you know, it's a bit long. It's about 180 feet long wall, okay, and about 3 feet wide. The bund is constructed well. It's not broken anywhere. It's not a KT type bandara, in the sense there is no door or anything like that. Water simply flows over when there is too much water. So, we are hoping that once we clear all this stuff, there will be plenty of water accumulation behind. Now I will also show you the farmer's land. In fact, that's what I'll show you first. Now, as the serpent said, the problem they're facing is every time in monsoon, Kalu gets flooded and it washes off their land. So you can see that cordoned off area, somebody is making Bhindi there. Now these areas are threatened. So as you can see, this is the protective wall that was constructed at one time, but obviously, you know, it's only a short wall, nothing beyond that, and nothing, it ends here. So this is the how the bund or the farmer's land and the river bank looks like. I'm walking actually on the river bed because it's all stone here. Right now, you can see that somebody has put a pump and a long pipeline exactly for that same bhindi growth, bhindi that is growing there. So if we have more water here, there will be more pumps like this, and more people will grow vegetables, and it will aid in their income. So this is how the bank is looking, including the bunds of the farmer's land. As we go further, then I will reverse and show you the river side, the waterfront side. Okay, because we have to get an understanding of how this is going to happen. Just for you to get a feel, see, that's the kind of accumulation of silt that you can see. Looking back to the wall, can you see that wall? See this accumulation? There is only some deep parts here where there is still some water. Okay, there will always be parts like this where there is always water. But after some time, this thing will reach that island. That island, you could go to the island walking and there will be no water there. We are starting work now. Okay, let me show you the farm side a little bit more, so you know how it's looking. What we are going to do is we are not going to venture into the deeper part where we are seeing water right now. We are going to start collecting this muck from where I'm actually walking. Okay. I showed you a long shot on this. I'm walking through stones and things like that. We expect that this will be about, you know, 5 feet. But obviously the riverbed is a sloping bed, so it will be varying length, different lengths at different places. This is mahua. This is a mahua ped. If you recognize brown leaves, new fresh leaves, it will be wonderful. It looks wonderful. Okay. So now this, look at this guy. How threatened he is. Can you see this? This fellow's farmland, his vegetable garden or whatever vegetable plot is so close. The river will clear it out in no time. So he's seriously threatened. He'll welcome this bund that we will create. We'll basically collect all this muck and pile up along the river bank, protecting their land. So this one, can you see? He's got bhindi again. Everybody's growing bhindi here. So we are starting work from that side because he still wants to pluck some bhindi for next 4 or 5 days. And he says, please start on that side. So by that time, I'll finish my bhindi. So can you see this, his land? Now, he's come on this side quite a lot. Somehow he's worked. But every time, the river washes off soil from his fields. Okay. We'll walk some more. All right. So you get an idea. Okay, we get a second pump. A second enterprising guy who has put a pump on a pipe and he's taking water. Maybe this guy only. This bhindi guy. Alright. Yeah, it is him. So no wonder people will be happy when we protect their fields. It is their soil that we are going to protect. Apart from, of course, regenerating, I would say, lot more capacity for water storage, where currently it is all occupied by just stones and sand and maybe some soil below. We don't know, but I think mostly it will be stones and sand. Okay, so this third patch, all right, we'll walk up to the last pump, okay, and then walk back. I'm not sure whether the funds we have will be able to clear up to here or not. I don't think so. But anyway, we'll walk up to there. This is the last pump currently. Because the pumps are there where the river still has some deeper parts. You know, there'll be some depth here. And so, there's still water. And this guy, oh, there are two pumps actually. Two pumps. It's a diesel pump, as you can see. In fact, the right thing would be, at some other point, to bring an electric line up to the river bank. So the farmer then, no individual farmer can pay for bringing their electric line to the river bank. But once the line is there, he can then take care of his power requirements. See, you can see these two lines. One is submerged pump. This one is on land. Okay. Quite thick 3-inch pipe. Oh, this is small, this is 2-inch pipe. Okay, so now you can see we have, luckily we have one dugout here. Somebody has dug out. So see, there's sand. This is not the bottom. I'm sure this can go another 4-5 feet. But how deep it is, we will only know when we start digging. Okay, so we'll probably come up to here. Okay, as much up to here as possible. Now take a long shot. Can you identify that wall? I hope you can. You see that island in between? Beyond that is the wall. You can identify pipelines. This is pipeline 1, pipeline 2, that white thing, pipeline 3, and that one at a distance, pipeline 4. Alright, so now we have done with the farmland. Now let's see how the river looks like. River has obviously receded quite a lot. Okay, just to take a look from there, like this, if I pan. Right up to there. So it's receded quite a bit. It touches those trees for sure, maybe beyond. But those trees it definitely touches. And it goes beyond. So this is the, currently these are the deeper parts. So what they say, villagers say that in this part water always remains. Okay. So this obviously must be some, maybe another 10-12 feet deep. We don't know, we have to see. Okay. So now I will show you the waterfront. This is how the waterfront will be. In fact, that waterfront is of no use. We have to see the bank. Because this is what we will be removing. So when we see it removed, this is what will be gone. Or at least parts of it will be gone. As much as we can afford to clear in what funds we have. Okay, this is a pretty large job actually. See, all of this shit will go. Sorry about that. Okay. So I think that's a good idea on what we will clear, where is the bund, what will be the use of it, and where will it be parked. Okay, and hopefully this will be helpful. In fact, you heard the sarpanch saying, he's the sarpanch of the whole Khutal Baragaon Gram Panchayat. He lives in this village which is called Wakalwadi. Okay, and he's a pretty knowledgeable guy. So there we are. I think our machine, we are hiring one Proclaim 220, I think it's called. And that machine is making its way to the river right now. And we have hired two tractor dumpers, yeah. And they'll also be here. And soon we'll start the work. Okay, I'm ending this video here now. Alright, wish us good luck. And I'm sure with this experience will be, you will not believe this. But I'm told 70% of such bunds are blocked out with silt in Maharashtra. Can you believe that? 70% of water storage capacity lost just because of no maintenance and nobody cared. Government just doesn't maintain this. That's it. Simple. In fact, when we approached the Tehsildar for this, okay, he quoted us a GR saying if the bund irrigates more than 100 acres of land, only then the government will give only diesel money. Okay, you still have to pay for the hire of the machine. And that too if your application is approved. Anything lesser than 100 acres of land, they say, is the responsibility of the villagers and the Gram Panchayat. Now, it's easy to say that. Okay, but most of the Gram Panchayats are so poor, they can't even run their regular affairs. They hardly have revenue. Okay. The money that they get is basically whatever the government schemes money that they get. But the government scheme money has to be spent on those specific schemes. And such things are not included. And so 12 years back or 15 years back, government constructed their bund. Initially it must have stored plenty of water. Okay, this is at least two, in my opinion, from the bund to there, where we walked a little bit more, is 600 feet. Okay, roughly. And this is roughly 200 feet. So that's the area, 600 feet by 200 feet by depth, we don't know. Depth could be, very, obviously will be varying. As you start from the farmer's land, it may be 1 foot, 1.5 foot, 2 feet, 3 feet, 4 feet, 5 feet, 10 feet, we don't know. So we have assumed that it's average 5 feet. Okay. And we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Okay. We're going to learn on this. And everybody will be wiser at the end. And the farmers will benefit. This village will benefit. Water will benefit. We will hold a lot more water during the next monsoon That's for sure. What is water harvesting? Water harvesting is basically you then don't let the water flow away. Flowing water, you slow down. Slowed down water, you stop. That means accumulate. Accumulated water, you let it percolate if the land allows percolation there. Now, here, I don't think it will allow percolation. It's all solid rock. But accumulation, yes. That's the whole purpose. We are accumulating water here by removing this thing. And so, what we are doing is, apart from whatever little benefits that he said, that their land will be protected, they will have more water for them to take more crops, vegetables, etc. We are doing water harvesting and serious water harvesting. And I tell you, this will be the easiest of the projects. Why? Because there's no risk. You can go wrong in your estimates and budgets and this, that, and other. But it is known that this place can store water. The wall is good and thick. We are leaving 30 feet. In fact, I will show you some of those landmarks that we have done. We are showing about leaving about 30 feet away from the wall so that we don't disturb anything related to the wall. And we will remove muck only 30 feet from 30 feet away from the wall. Reason being, with all this muck, this, that, the, whatever leakages might have been there, have been plugged. Now, nobody wants to disturb that. Let it be as it is, and then worry about only after 30 feet onwards. That's what we're going to do. As we go, you will see marks on the ground, white marks on the ground. Those are nothing but... Okay, I think I'll stop the video now. Okay, bye. I'm also tired.